Little Shortcakes, I'm Tomoyo and welcome to my channel! So today I decided to continue my series on Lifestyle Lolita 101. So today we're gonna talk about how to lolify and embellish your everyday life. As I said in the first part of this series, I already did that series on my blog, so if you prefer a written format, I'm gonna link it in the description below. So today I'm going to give you basically some inspiration or some tips and tricks on how to lolify or add some Lolita aesthetic to your everyday life. This is more catered towards like aesthetic and decor rather than hobbies and activities. This is gonna be in my third video. This one is really more catered towards more material things than activities and things you can do. These are just some inspiration that I've gathered with the years. This is not like some guidelines or things that you must do to be a lifestyle Lolita. This is just for informational and inspiration purposes. So I hope they may inspire you if you want to add more Lolita aesthetic into your everyday life. So if you want to incorporate Lolita or Lolita aesthetic elements to your daily life, you must ask yourself, what would a refined little child or the nobility from another era would have in place of that object that would serve the same purpose but would be more fancy and cute and elegant? The first thing would be cute or antique furniture or antique looking. Nowadays, antique looking furniture is a little bit more hard to find in mainstream stores. Like, I don't know if you can see my dresser here. I got it new from a store, but it was the only model that was kind of more fancy looking. But you can also try to like DIY or repaint some old furniture. You can try to embellish them with some ribbons, some lace, some flowers on it. Again, I'm gonna put some examples here that I found or from my own home. You can also try to make or buy covers for your couch or your chairs. And honestly, if you are on a pinch and you don't want to invest in some couch covers, you can take some cute or elegant pillowcase or bedspreads or sheets, and you can also thrift them too. Like, it doesn't have to be new or expensive. Before I had my sofa covers, I had just some bed sheets. They did the job and they were flowery and elegant. This one is a really common one, but curtains in place of blinds. They are much more elegant, just as functional, and they are quite easy to make if you want to make them yourself. You can also like tie them with some pretty ribbons or pretty tassels, and I think that's very lifestyle Lolita indeed. A pretty and intricate carpet. Some of them come in like cute or fun shapes. I would look for either sweet Sanrio type carpeting, again I can put some example here, or some kind of Turkish carpeting. I got mine for my entryway by searching for like intricate design carpeting, and I got it from like Walmart. It's not that complicated to find nowadays. Also, you can have like a small one to decorate your floor when you take outfit pictures. I've seen some beautiful like Cardcaptor Sakura ones or Sailor Moon ones that are really, really, really cute on AliExpress. Again, I can put examples here. Or you can have a big statement carpet in your room, like something very intricate and elegant in the center of your living room or under your dinner table or something like that. Another thing, decorative pillows and blankets. for your bed, for your couch, or just to decorate like the corner of a room to make yourself a little reading nook or gaming nook or something. Like, I have one in my living room that's just like a big paw-shaped pillow, and I also have a lot of blankets around my home because I live in Canada and in winter it's cold, and it's very cold inside my home specifically because I don't have a basement, so I'm always pretty much wrapped in a blanket whenever it's not summer. So you can have cute ones and use them as decoration too. Another thing, fairy lights and chandeliers. They are quite easy to find at thrift stores nowadays, especially like chandeliers. I've seen them for quite cheap prices into flea markets and stuff. And you can, of course, repaint them. And fairy lights, I love them as night lights, especially. I have some around my bed that I use like in place of night lights. And they are the kind of lighting that always had a more magical touch to a room. Other than that, plushies, dolls, toys, they can be used as decoration and they can be also thrifted for quite cheap. Some Lolitas, like me, like to collect retro toys and retro plushies, and they're very aesthetic and fun to have on display. It's quite easy to thrift them, I want to say. Like, every time I go thrifting, I always see some kind of cute vintagey plushie or antique dolls from a grandma collection that are very cheap indeed. Also, artwork. You can have artwork on the walls or a statement wallpaper. Personally, I like to support artists that makes interesting artwork that are in sync with my aesthetic, or some fan arts of my favorite fandoms. And if you want to like up your game aesthetically, you can put them in a cute frame or an elegant frame that you can also thrift and DIY, so it looks more fancy and more Lolita-like around your place. For your kitchen, you can have an intricate tablecloth or a nice centerpiece, or something that you put like across the table. I'm gonna put the word here because I don't remember it in English. And it's not only for like your dinner table, like a lot of my side tables have some kind of antique crochet centerpiece. Again, I can put some pictures here to tell you what I mean. I am someone that loves like putting some interesting trinkets on display just because I think they are pretty, and these can also be used as decor or a centerpiece for your tables in your house. A set of towels you can keep on display for tea towels, hand towels, face towels, etc. I saw some nice ones at Geeky Convention with like fan art on them. You don't have to always use them because they are usually there to be pretty. I think it's something nice to have on display, especially if they have like a nice design or some cute embroidery on them. Again, for the kitchen, an aesthetic tableware and cutlery set, and actually using it. Sometimes when you have pretty or some fancy cutlery or tableware, you don't really tend to use it, like it's your grandma's heirloom. But I found some cute flowery one at a flea market that were really, really cheap for what they were. Like, I got it for a fraction of what they would sell online, so it doesn't break my heart as much to use them. Keep an eye on it, you may find some treasure. And if you also want to invest in something new, I've seen some cute cutlery set on Amazon. I have a cute like rainbow oil slick one that I got off of Amazon that wasn't that expensive for what it is. Again, I will show them here. Keep an eye out for deals at flea markets and thrift stores. Of course, when you say lifestyle Lolita, you say flowers. You can decorate with flowers, either real or fake ones. If you have the luxury of being able to afford and decorate with pretty fresh flowers every week. You are one of the lucky ones. And it's interesting because it can brighten any room and brings a nice fragrance also. But honestly, I think that fake flowers are just as good too, and they stay pretty and the same all the time. You can change them to match your mood or your decor. I think it's very nice to create a beautiful bouquet that can send some subtle message to your guests with the language of flowers. And of course, you can change them according to the occasion. Like, you can do that with real flowers too, but I think that with fake flowers, you have more possibilities. You can add some charms or keychain to your bags, cell phone, your game consoles, etc. They are very cute, and some brands make some keychain or like cell phone charm. I have a baby, the Starshine Bright one. You can also try to find some phone case or some protective covers that suit the Lolita aesthetic. Whenever I get a new phone or a new game console, this is like the first thing I do. I get a beautiful case for it and I like to decorate it all pretty. Also, you can carry some Lolita-like things for when you are on the go, like a nice handkerchief instead of some tissues. You can have like a cute flowery hand fan for sunny days or for hot days. A nice pocket mirror instead of using like your phone or something. Some old-fashioned candy or mints. I love Les Anis de Flavigny. They are my favorite mints to have around, and especially like the rose one. And they have, the original one is really good, and they also have some orange or lemon one that I really really like, but the rose one are the most Lolita-like in my opinion. And also, the packaging is so aesthetic, let's be real. You can also carry a pocket-sized book to read instead of being on your phone. A small pocket notebook to use as a journal to write like things about your day or something you find interesting, or just to take some notes. A small sewing kit. I've seen some pretty vintage and antique ones in thrift shops, and I think they are very useful to have, especially if you are her daily Lolita. You can also carry around a small powder pouch for when you need to reapply your makeup during the day or when you need to fix your nails or things like that. Also, using cute or elegant stationery, pretty pens, pretty pencils, fountain pens are very lifestyle Lolita. Some cute notebooks and notepads. You can also try to have some cute or elegant school supplies if you are still in school. The Jolie collection by Hilroy. They are very, very aesthetic for Lolitas, and they are pretty easy to find in mainstream stores. At least they were when I was in university. Of course, I use that collection since college, because how could I not? Also, you can try to use products that have a cute or elegant packaging. I am someone that cannot resist a cute packaging. When something comes in a nice flowery or vintage container, I got to have it. And also, you can always like reuse the packaging for something else or to keep on display if you like. You can also use candles, melts, perfumes, or essential oils in your place. I think that having an olfactory dimension to the lifestyle is something that is very comforting, and it adds something else to the Lolita lifestyle and aesthetic. You can also try to make your own potpourri for your closet with dry flowers or essential oils. And honestly, if all else fails, you can always toss some cookies in the oven for that fresh bakery sweet smell. Another tip, you can keep trinkets and pretty objects on display to decorate your living space. Things like music boxes, pocket watch, snow globes, interesting magazines or pictures or cute packaging, accessories, jewelry, hand fans, parasols, hats, crowns, hand mirror, postcards that are repurposed or something. They can make pretty nice decoration if they are used well. Also, I firmly believe that the Lolita aesthetic and that Lolita lifestyle is far from being a minimalist, so go overboard with it. It's about opulence and luxury. You can also try to put some lullable music whenever you are at home, whether it's classical music, lo-fi, visual K, some anime music, 50s pop music, like any music that you associate with Lolita and the lifestyle. It can help make your space feel more lifestyle Lolita and more complete, kind of like the olfactory dimension. You can have an auditory dimension. And also, there's no shame in bursting into a song like if you were in a musical while cooking dinner. Also, try to match your utility objects to your Lolita style or aesthetic. For example, things around your bathroom. My favorite place to find more Lolita aesthetic utility objects are, funny enough, it's the dollar store. They often have like some kitschy things. Like in spring and summer, they often have like cute pastel things for Easter or Valentine's Day also. And also for my gothic Lolita friends, you can always shop there during Halloween. A lot of my friends will get their utility objects during Halloween at the dollar store. They have cups, they have things to bake, and they will always have some cute decor that you can use all year round. This is one of my most useful and practical tips. You can use like typical Lolita elements as storage or display. Around my house, I like to keep like not so aesthetic things into more aesthetic ones to hide them so they are not on sight. I've used old teapot as storage around my vanity and around my kitchen. I also use a pretty pastry stand as a display for my bag charm and some headband collection that I have. Porcelain jars are very useful to keep things inside, and they are pretty easy to find at thrift stores. And of course, they are very like kitschy and elegant and Lolita. And finally, my last tip. You can wear like lollyable clothes whenever you are not able to wear Lolita. Like a nice frilly or lacy nightgown as loungewear, or a cute like kitschy like graphic tee with some bloomers. You can also try to find like a 50s style like sailor-ish swimsuit. And also, I think that Baby the Star Shine Bright also released a bikini in the past. Or you can have like a frilly pastel parka along pastel sweatpants for working out. You can also add some patches or lace or embroidery into it to make them more Lolita-like. So overall, making your life more Lolita or more fitting into the Lolita aesthetic, it's all about filling your daily life with practical everyday objects that match the Lolita aesthetic. You have to think kind of outside the box and think about what could fill the same function but be more cute. Again, my favorite place to find things for my home home and my lifestyle and my decor in general is thrift stores, flea markets, the dollar store. You can also try and find some gems on AliExpress or Amazon. Also, I would look independent store that you have locally, because sometimes like gift store, fancy decor stores will most likely have some things that can fit your aesthetic, so you don't have to order them online and you support a local business. But yeah, honestly, I will go thrifting first if you have the option to do it, because that's honestly where I found at least half of my decor and lifestyle Lolita things in my house. And also it's cheap. It's cheaper than it will have been to buy new. So these are pretty much all that I could gather and find with my research that I did. Also, keep in mind that this is for inspirational. You don't need to have all of this to be a lifestyle Lolita. This is just for your information. So, as I said in the beginning of the video, in my next video on my Lifestyle Lolita 101 series, I will cover the activities and hobbies that are related to the Lolita lifestyle. So stay tuned on my channel if you want to learn more about that. So yeah, I hope you liked my video today and it gave you more inspiration on how to lolify your everyday life. Please don't forget to like, comment and subscribe if you aren't yet. It lets me know that you enjoy my content. And a little reminder that I have a Ko-fi page and an Amazon wishlist in the description below. So until next time, please stay safe, take care, and we will see each other in my next video, my little shortcakes. Bye! Here is a little message from Tomeo from the future. That's why I don't have the same outfit. I just wanted to pop by and say thank you to our first featured shortcake, Junkat Art! So thank you again, Junkat, for your support and your love, and we're going to see each other in my next video. Bye my little shortcakes, take care!